Seagrasses and mangroves are among the most productive ecosystems on Earth. These coastal marine plants use their leaves, roots, and tissue to absorb and store greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide while cleaning microalgae and other dead carbon matter from the sea. As mangroves and seagrasses grow and die, captured carbon, or blue carbon, cycles into thick layers of sediment on the seafloor, where it is stored, undisturbed, for centuries and even millennia. As far back as the Islamic Golden Age, researchers such as Ibn Sina or Avicenna have been studying the natural history of the Red Sea and the life cycle of its mangroves. KAUST researchers continue to build on this knowledge about mangroves and seagrasses in the Red Sea region.
At KAUST, we have been studying mangroves and seagrasses across the Red Sea. We've studied 12 species of seagrass and also about 30 stands of mangroves all along the Red Sea. Mangroves and seagrass are able to lock carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and then put it in the sediments and the soils where they sequester this carbon over millenary time scales. They're also able to filter out plankton from the water column and settle their carbon also safely in their soil. This carbon accumulates over millennia and represents a major stock of carbon that is protected from being emitted from the atmosphere in as long as the habitat remains. So protecting mangroves and seagrasses is a very effective strategy to mitigate climate change. We have now discovered also another mechanism through which mangroves contribute to climate change mitigation, because mangroves, when they're set in a carbonate bedrock, like they are in the Red Sea, they dissolve the carbonate and release alkalinity that helps to trap carbon dioxide from the atmosphere into seawater. So the carbon sequestration capacity of these small mangroves from the Red Sea is remarkable and make them be the champions of carbon sequestration in the biosphere. Even though they look small and not much, they're really very important. They also play important ecological roles along with seagrass into providing habitat for biodiversity and also protecting our shores. So much of the fisheries in the Red Sea depend on the mangroves and seagrasses that provide habitat for the juvenile stages of those fish and also crabs and shrimp. So these habitats are very important, and we refer to them as blue carbon habitats because of their very important role in sequestering carbon. And mangroves, because they sit in the interface between land and ocean, they're actually pollinated by a special species of bees from which we derive honey as well. So they do not only provide services at sea, they also provide services on land as well. And globally, we have lost about half of the global surface of mangroves and seagrass, but in the Red Sea, they have been rather well conserved. And over the last 30 years, we have documented a 13% increase in mangrove areas. And here in KAUST, due to the conservation measures that managers of KAUST have taken, mangroves have expanded by 20%, above the area of mangroves that was in place before KAUST was built. So restoring mangroves is very important as we enter the UN decade of ecosystem restoration. And it's a major strategy to both contribute to climate change mitigation and also improve the health of our oceans.
Mangroves and seagrasses provide a home, food source, and nursery to marine animals and wildlife, including turtles, fish, sharks, dugongs, and many species of birds. Mangroves additionally prevent erosion and buffer coasts from storms. These mangroves are a great resource for researchers and wildlife enthusiasts of all ages. KAUST is at the forefront of green and sustainable projects through innovative research and environmentally conscious management plans. Its vision and goals are helping to inspire environmental action from leaders in the kingdom and collaborators around the world.